Logos Hope, the world's largest floating library, carries a stock of 500,000 books with a vision to bring knowledge, help and hope to the people of the world. Logos Hope is a fourth vessel belonging to GBA Ships, a charity organization based in Germany. Logos Hope was constructed in the year 1973, was initially named as Gustav Vasa. It was originally built and designed as a passenger ferry, and it used to sail the North Atlantic routes then. In the year 1983, the ship changed hands to Smiral Line. It was then named as Naruna, which then sailed the Faroe Islands and Denmark. By 2004, GBA Ships had raised sufficient funds to acquire the vessel, and she then underwent extensive renovations for her new role. The word logos in Greek traditionally means word, thought, principle, or speech.
My name is Pat Tracy. I hail from the United States, and I've been with the project for about 15 years, but only on this ship for about 6 weeks now. I started sailing in 1968, and I won't tell you how many years ago that was, but it was a while. And with the U.S. Navy for 20 years before getting involved with GBA Ships. And so actually it was a fairly smooth transition from one to the other. Most merchant ships these days have very small crews. Our crew is on the order of almost 400. And so I'm very familiar with working with a crew that size, with doing teaching and training and those sorts of things. So it was a pretty smooth transition for us. All of our crew and staff are volunteers. Other than the licensed officers, most everyone else is trained on the job. And so we teach them everything from basic safety training on up through their watchkeeper training and the advanced certificates that they need. So one of the nice things is if I can't sleep at night, it's because I haven't done a good job of training. So we work hard at training, our crews work hard at learning, and it works together very well. We have to meet the same kind of requirements and safety standards as any passenger vessel does, and obviously, like anyone else, we're also subject to port state and to flag state inspections and so forth, and and so we work hard at keeping that up and keeping our people up on the step, and so that makes for fewer exciting days. Let's put it that way.
Over 40 million people in 158 different countries have walked up the ship's gangway to visit this floating book fair. For many, this is the first ever opportunity to purchase good quality literature at a fraction of its retail value. Many people without the means to study have learned vital skills and have been able to enhance their lives through a purchase from over 7,000 available titles, including books for studies, professional and career interests, individual development and personal growth.
My name is Norma Hernandez. I'm from Mexico. I've been working with this ship for 3 years and a half now. Before, back home, I was an account assistant. And then I saw one of the ships, which is called Logos 2, in 2003. I used to help in that ship in the book fair. Well, one of the reasons that really impacted me to come to the ship, it was because I saw the people working in my own country. They didn't speak the language. We speak Spanish. They didn't speak Spanish. They didn't eat, you know, like our traditional food, but still they were enjoying it. And I think that was something that really impacted my life, that I would like to serve as well other people in other countries. So Logos Hope brings knowledge, help, and hope to the people of the world. And that was one of the main reasons why I decided to join the ship, because I wanted to serve others as well. So for now, I've been as volunteer for 3.5 years, and I have seen different ports. I have seen as well how many people have come and volunteer in this ship. I joined in Logos 2, which was the last ship. When I joined in 2007, we stopped the activities because we had this new ship, Logos Hope. Actually, when we joined Logos Hope, it was completely empty. You have been around, you have seen now the new carpets, the dining room, you can see the bookshop. When I joined in that time, we didn't have nothing like that. It was all completely empty, so we had to work in the rebuilding. It took us for a while, a couple of years, to really work in that. I have seen people coming on board, not just giving their time, but as well some people giving their finances to help to this ship, and as well some people that say, okay, I have no time to go for 2 years and volunteer there, but maybe I have some skills. So I have seen people coming to lay down the carpets, coming and work as electrician for a couple of months just to fix the ship and to get ready what we have now. Each one of us, we are volunteers, but we have different skills, different abilities. We work in different departments. There is departments as an office, as well people that works in the galley, which is the kitchen, people that works in the engine room, the engine people, people that works in the accommodation team or cleaning team. And each one of us receive training. Before we join any department, we have someone that train us, that give us advices and give us the training, how should we respond to any of those activities. And I think for us it's as well a good place where we can not just learn something new, but as well shape our abilities or skills that we have. We can learn so much and we can develop so much in it. Of course, you don't stay longer in one department. When I joined the ship in 2007, I was working in the accommodation team, cleaning around the ship. I was called an angel because I'm walking up and down the stairs, cleaning in one place to another one. And then I joined the advanced preparation team, which is the team that goes ahead of the ship to prepare the ship's arrival, working with permissions, customs, migrations, and then bring the ship in port.
Cultural variety abounds with over 40 nations meeting on board. For visitors, opportunity to meet the crew, provide insights into the wider world, while interactive programs offer fresh perspectives on living in a multicultural society. For the volunteer crew, time on board the ship provides a chance to experience countries and cultures for themselves, as well as opportunities to learn valuable skills for their future.
Hello, my name is Gerard and I'm from Holland. For the last 3 years, I've been working on the ship, the Logos Hope and the Doulas. Before I came to the ship, I was working as a civil engineer in the Netherlands. I was working in an office and I was thinking by myself, what am I doing here? Am I just having a job and getting money? Or should I go and help the needed people in the world? So I got to hear about the ship when it came to Holland in 2004. When I came there on board, I really was sold and I thought, this is something that I want to do. I want to go and join this ship and I want to work on it and be a blessing for many people in this world. So that's how I came to the ship. I left my job and now I work as a volunteer here for the last 3 years. I started off working in the kitchen for 10 months. I was doing the dishes, just cleaning up the dishes on the ship. And after doing the dishes, I was called for another job on the ship, what is called the advanced preparation work, so-called the lineup team. With the lineup team, you go ahead of the ship and you prepare all the arrangements to be made for the ship to arrive in a port. So in the next port, there's a team who is doing all the preparations, like permissions and media and all the teams that are going out. So I've been doing that for the last 2 years, that job. And with that, I've been to many different countries and really seen the need of those countries and to help and to find a program what is needed in this country. So I'm really enjoying. This job is a voluntary work, so nobody gets paid on board. Even the captain, he doesn't get paid. We all are here as volunteers to serve the people in the world, to serve the nations around the world.
With around 50 different nationalities represented on board, Logos Hope Community is regarded as a genuine expression of international goodwill and understanding. The crew and staff are all non-salaried volunteers, including many of them serving in their professional capacity, such as seafarers, engineers, electricians, nurses, teachers, and cooks. Sponsorship from friends, family members, and civic organizations enables crew members to serve on board. Most of the crew are in their 20s or 30s, from the captain to the new staff member. Each person has a job that is essential to keep the ship running.
So my name is Raluca, I come from Romania. I've been on board the ship for 1 year and 4 months already. And my job right now on the ship is a secretary for the teams that go in advance of the ship to prepare for the visit, to get the permissions and make the publicity, let the people know that we're coming. And also, before I came to the ship, my job was a teacher at the kindergarten. I did that for a few years. And then one of the ships came to my country, and I saw how big impact people on the ship can do in a nation, and I wanted to be a part of it. So I applied, and 1 year after that, I came to the ship, to the Logos Hope. We have three main goals, and those are bringing knowledge, help, and hope. Knowledge through the books that we have on board, help through the humanitarian projects that we also do onshore, not just on board and through events, and hope to the people that live like I did once upon a time in my country with no hope, thinking that nobody cares about us. So that's, for me, that's the most special of all.
Over 40 million visitors have passed through the onboard book fair since the ship began sailing in 1970. A figure equivalent to roughly one in every 170 of the world's total population. Visitors to Logos Hope are offered a selection of about 7,000 titles for the entire family across a wide range of categories, including science, sports, hobbies, cookery, arts, economics, medicine, dictionaries, languages, and philosophy. A visual presentation called The Journey of Life, an international cafe, is also arranged on board.
My name is Emma and I'm from Sweden. I have been on board the Logos Hope now for about 21 months. Back home I was a high school teacher teaching Swedish and mathematics, and I also studied information and communication science. And on board the ship I work in the book fair, and right now my position is that I'm assistant Hope Experience Manager. So basically I take care of all the administration and planning for the book fair. We try to have as wide variety as possible, but some of our main focuses is children's books, reference books, dictionaries, atlases. We have also a big collection of hobbies and sports, cookery, novels, our Christian books, of course. Well, in many ports like here, we get containers that is sent from our head offices with books. In some ports, depending on where we are and what language is normally spoken in those places. We also have our people find out local partners, so we can buy some books in the local language. But mainly we have mostly English titles. Some of the books that we have on board is hard to get in some of the places that we go, and that's the whole point of moving around, that we can bring them from one place to another. And many times when we come into ports, people are generally very happy that we come, and when they look at the books, and when we often hear that we have a good collection and that they're having a hard time finding these kind of books otherwise. So we do feel that we fulfill a need to bring these books.
Publishers often donate books that have been removed from circulation in the first world countries after new editions have been released. This allows Logos Hope to offer books to a fraction of the original cost to people in developing countries. For each port visit, every effort is made to ensure that local language materials are made available. These supplement the large selection of English books offered to visitors in every destination Logos Hope visits. Apart from book sales, Logos Hope also extends literary aid to people in developing countries. In the course of our service, we have donated textbooks and reference volumes to individuals, schools, libraries, community groups, colleges, universities around the globe. More than anything, the environs reading or searching for interesting books aboard a ship will be a big thrill. This world's largest floating library will continue on its journey to bring knowledge, help, and hope to the people of the world. We wish them all the very best.